wondering how the situation in Southeast Asia right now with the vaccine rollout update and which country will open first for tourists. That's what we're going to find out right now. Hello, this is Trang from Yung Global's communication team. I know a lot of you are eager to know about the virus update, vaccine rollout update, as well as travel restriction to many Southeast Asia countries. So this video is for you. And before we reviewing this topic, kindly remind that we have many videos regarding life in Vietnam that you may be interested in. So make sure that you check out all of our videos. And for more videos regarding the up-to-date news regarding Southeast Asia, make sure that you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you. First of all, I want to talk about Southeast Asia coronavirus updates. As for the time of making this video, on August 11th, the numbers are provided by JHUCSSE COVID-19 data. Indonesia recorded total cases of 3.7 million with 100,012 deaths. That rate is 2.99%. From July 28, Indonesia is seeing a decrease in new cases every day, with about 31,000 cases on the last 7 days. The Philippines has 1.69 million cases with 29,000 deaths. That rate is 1.74%. From July 27, the number of cases just keep increasing every day, with about 9,700 cases on average during the last 7 days. Vietnam has total cases of 242,000 and nearly 4,500 deaths. That rate is 1.85%. At the moment, Vietnam is not seeing an increase in infective cases. On August 5th until now, on average, Vietnam recorded 8,500 cases a day. Thailand has 817,000 cases and nearly 6,800 deaths. That rate is 0.83%. Cases in Thailand is going up every single day, and during the last 7 days, on average, Thailand recorded 20,500 cases a day. Myanmar in total recorded 341,000 cases and about 12,500 deaths. That rate is 3.65%. From August 3rd to now, there is an increase in new cases found in Myanmar. About 3,700 cases are found every single day. Malaysia has 1.32 million cases with 11,300 deaths. That rate is 0.86%. Since August 3rd, Malaysia has seen a steady increase in cases every single day, and now it recorded nearly 20,000 new cases on average each day. Cambodia has about 83,000 cases and 1,600 deaths. Death rate is 1.94%. From July 28, Cambodia is seeing a decrease in infective cases, and only 486 new cases were discovered on August 11. Laos has about 9,000 cases in total and only 8 deaths. With that rate is 0.09%. On average, Laos recorded 265 new cases on August 5th to August 12th. And even though new cases are going up, but the increase is trivial. Singapore has the least death rate so far in all Southeast Asia countries, with nearly 66,000 cases in total and only 43 deaths. With impressive death rate 0.07%, and from August 3rd, the number of cases has decreased and only 117 new cases were found on August 11. Timor-Leste recorded around 12,000 cases and 29 deaths. That rate is 0.24% and only 104 cases found on average from the last 7 days. Brunei recorded 54 new cases on August 11, added to the total number of nearly 500 cases with 3 deaths, and that rate is 0.61%. Starting August 7, Brunei recorded a dramatic increase in infected cases that Brunei has never seen before. According to this research, most of the new cases found in Southeast Asia are from the Delta variant from India, making Indonesia as the place with most death and most hard-hit area in all region. And Brunei had the least amount of deaths with only 3 people so far. Now that we saw the COVID situation in all Southeast Asian countries, let's go over to the vaccine rollout. Below information is from Asian Briefing from Desen Shira and Associates, published on January 28, 2020, and it was last updated on July 27, 2021. In Indonesia, 6.7% of the population is vaccinated. The main source of vaccines is from the Chinese-made vaccine, Sinovac, provided to citizens from 18 to 59 years old. At the moment, the Indonesian government is in discussions with China to provide more vaccine supplies. The vaccine needs to pass halal certification to use, and it is unsure how Indonesia can have enough vaccines. The Philippines has 5.7% of vaccinated population right now, and the government aims to vaccinate 70% of the Filipinos in 2021. On March 1, the Philippines finally began to legally roll out COVID-19 vaccines, with the first doses from Sinovac. As of July 25, 2021, about 11.1 million people received the first of 2 doses of COVID-19 vaccine in the Philippines. In contrast, roughly 6.1 million already received both doses of the vaccine. As for vaccine rollout in Vietnam, we have made several videos that I recommend you to watch. We deliver live in Vietnam, up-to-date news regarding Vietnam vaccine rollout as well. So make sure that you check it out. Thank you. In addition, Vietnam also signed an agreement with the Direct Investment Fund from Russia Federation on the closure of COVID-19 vaccine tube Sputnik V in Vietnam. And the first batch of Vietnam-made Sputnik V were already finished and was sent to Russia for quality check. At the moment, besides receiving the vaccines from many countries around the world, Vietnam is also working hard to making its own vaccine, Nanocovax, and Nanocovax is in the 3rd trial at the moment, and if in the best scenario, it will finish its 3rd trial this August. In Thailand, a nationwide vaccine program officially kicked off on June 7 with Sinovac vaccines from China and AstraZeneca. Concerns are also raised as Thailand health authorities relying on AstraZeneca shots produced by a company owned by the country's king. In addition, Thailand aims to vaccinate 70% of the population by the end of this year. As for Myanmar, has administered at least 3,500,000 doses of COVID vaccine so far, about 3.2% of the country's population. Myanmar is seeking assistance from the Gavi and COVAX programs to acquire vaccines, while Australia is also providing financial relief. In Malaysia, the vaccines are 20% from Pfizer, 10% from AstraZeneca, 10% from COVAX facilities, 21.9% from Sinovac, 10.9% from CanSino Bio, and 10% from Russia's Sputnik V. On June, the government aimed to deploy vaccination drugs to areas where people might have difficulty getting to immunization center. Malaysia went mobile with its mass vaccination program with the rollout of the first of 40 vaccine drugs set to hit the highways. Singapore also aimed to vaccinate 2 in 3 residents against COVID-19 and ramped up its COVID-19 vaccination program on June 26. For every 100 people in Singapore, 74 have received the first dose and 53 are fully vaccinated as at July 24. Singapore has the highest rate of fully vaccinated population in Southeast Asia with 53.8%. Cambodia is expected to import vaccine from both Russia and China, while Laos is implementing trialing the Russia Sputnik V vaccine and is also in discussion with China for vaccine supply. On the same note, Brunei is having enough vaccine to vaccinate 50% of its population, and Timor-Leste have just Timor-Leste have 100,000 and 800 doses to vaccinate its people, and this is the second batch of vaccine come from the COVAX facilities. Now that we understand the vaccine rollout in many Southeast Asian countries, we can move on to the travel restrictions to understand how we can travel to each country. In Indonesia, passengers are not allowed to enter and transit except national of Indonesia. Foreigners with temporary stay permit, ITAS, or permanent stay permit, ITAP. Foreigners with diplomatic or service visa, foreigners with a diplomatic or service stay permit, foreigners with a visa issued after 31 March 2020. Foreigners, expats working on strategic national projects, medical aid worker or food assistance worker for humanitarian purposes, crew of air, sea or land transport. Furthermore, you are also required to have a medical certificate with negative COVID-19 results issued 7 days upon arrival, and you will still be subjected to 14-day quarantine. If you don't have the test result, you will need to go through a medical screening and be quarantined at the facilities for 14 days as well. If you wish to enter the Philippines at the moment, conditions set by Inter-Agency Task Force IATFR. Filipinos, foreigners bound or minor children of Filipinos, children with special needs regardless of age are Filipinos, foreign parent of minor Filipinos, foreign parent of Filipino children with special needs regardless of age, accredited foreign government and international organization officials and their dependents, foreign airline crew members, foreign seafarer with NIC visas, foreign nationals with the following long-term visas, Section 13 series of the Commonwealth Act number 613, as amended. 13 quota, 13A, 13B, C, D, E, G visas, RA 7919 visa, EO 324 visa, Native Point visa, temporary resident visa related to Section 13 of CA 613 as amended. In addition, foreigners also need to book accredited quarantine facility before coming into the Philippines with pre-booked COVID-19 testing providers and have a valid visa for entry. For travel restriction update in Vietnam, we have made several videos, so please check out our videos in the pop-up right-hand banner to see that video, to know about who and how you can legally come to Vietnam at the moment. On the other hand, Thailand is opening its door for fully vaccinated tourists. On July 1, the island of Phuket reopened to vaccinated foreign visitors without quarantine requirements. Holders of US, Canada, UK and Australia passport are among those not required to obtain a visa when entering Thailand for tourism purposes, and will be permitted to stay in Thailand for a period of not exceeding 45 days on each visit. But you are still required to obtain a certificate of entry upon arrival. Tourists from countries not on the visa exemption list can apply for special tourist visa. Thailand has released an online step-by-step guide offering detailed information on entry procedures, so please check it out. For visitors who want to visit Myanmar at the moment, tourist entry is banned from in Myanmar until July 31, 2021. Flights to Myanmar are suspended. This does not apply to Medivac flights. Passengers must have an approval from Ministry of Foreign Affairs Myanmar and a negative PCR test result issued at most 72 hours before departures. This does not apply to national of Myanmar. After that, you will be subjected to 10 days of quarantine. For now, Malaysia has suspended on visa exemptions and visa on arrival facilities. In Malaysia, passengers are not allowed to enter Malaysia except national of Malaysia, permanent residents of Malaysia with my PR card, passengers with an official passport on a diplomatic mission, students with an immigration approval, passengers with a sticker label visa on their passport specifying that they are spouse or children of nationals of Malaysia, passengers with a Malaysia My Second Home MM2H with a blank entry permission from Immigration Department of Malaysia, citizen under reciprocal Greenland RGL and the Periodic Commuting Agreement PCA program, subject to terms and conditions. Passenger must install My Sejahtera app in their smartphone and must present a letter of approval entry permit issued by a Malaysian representation to carrier prior to departure and to immigration upon arrival. Furthermore, passengers will need to go through medical screening and will be subjected to 10 to 14 days quarantine. For passengers who did the COVID-19 RT-PCR screening within 72 hours prior to departure will be quarantined for 7 days from the day of arrival. However, you are required to make the payment online via MySafe Travel or My QR application by MYEG for your quarantine costs and COVID-19 test prior to your departure. Please also make sure to save proof of payment. In Cambodia, all visa exemptions, visa on arrival and e-visa are all suspended. And this is not applied to people holding visa A, which is diplomatic visa, and visa B, official visas. At the moment, entering Cambodia through land borders are impossible because Cambodia, Thailand, and Cambodia, Vietnam, and Cambodia, Laos land border are all closed. However, sponsor, investor, business persons, company staffs, experts, skilled workers, technicians, and family members can still enter Cambodia. All foreigners arriving in Cambodia will be subjected to a COVID-19 test on arrival, as well as requiring a COVID-19 test before flying. For international restriction to Laos, the government of Laos, BDR, has suspended the visa on arrival service at all international entry points. No visa are being issued to people traveling from a country with cases of COVID-19, including the UK. However, the Laos authorities may consider granting special entry permission for foreigners such as expert technicians or foreign nationals that are needed for essential projects who wish to come to Laos. All foreigners must present a certificate of entry issued by the MFA, a completed health declaration form, and a fit to fly certificate issued no more than 72 hours prior to travel. Passengers will also need to take and pay for a COVID test. You will be admitted to a hospital for treatment if the result is positive. Otherwise, you will be subjected to 14-day quarantine. For arriving in Singapore, Singapore citizens and Singapore permanent residents may return to Singapore without seeking entry approval. At the moment, short-term visits by foreigners are currently only allowed for countries regions with low risk of COVID-19 importation, which includes Brunei, mainland China, New Zealand, and Hong Kong. Travelers from all countries, regions may enter Singapore on a short-term basis to attend to a family crisis, for example, death or critical illness of a family member in Singapore. Only a maximum of 2 visitors per case is allowed. Travelers may be required to take a PCR test within 72 hours before departing to Singapore. All travelers will also take a PCR test upon arrival in Singapore. For entering Timor-Leste at the moment, you need to have a negative PCR test result before you coming in and also undergo 14 days quarantine at a designated facility. Likely will be at your own expense and you will be required to have many mandatory testing as well. But if you are come from the country with the Delta variant and you can show proof that you are fully vaccinated, you will only need to go for 5 days of quarantine, and depend on the local that you are stay in, you may be required to have some mandatory testing as well. Lastly, Brunei. On Monday, July 12, 2021, the resumption of the reciprocal Green Lane Agreement between Brunei and Singapore took effect. For people who wish to enter Brunei, entry travel pass will be issued for essential business travel, including official travel, student, individual primarily here for the purpose of medical treatment, compassionate and other special circumstances such as parents, spouse or other immediate family member of Brunei citizen or residents. Important note for eligibility of entry travel pass. Travelers must have remained within the country of departure for the last 14 days prior to departure for Brunei. Transit YN route to Brunei is only permitted in a country with an equivalent or lower risk category as per Ministry of Health risk assessment. The traveler may not leave the airport while in transit. In addition, travelers are required to undertake pre-departure COVID-19 tests within 72 hours prior to departure. Upon arrival, travelers will also be required to undergo self-isolation at hotel accommodation for a period of between 2 to 14 days depending on the self-isolation notice that is given upon arrival as determined by the Ministry of Health Risk Assessment. Above are our research about Southeast Asia virus, vaccine, and also travel restriction roundup. So I hope that you find this video helpful. So if you like this video, make sure that you hit like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you, and I see you in the next video. Goodbye.